Hokimai anō. It's 40 years today since the infamous flower bomb test at Eden Park between the All Blacks and the Springboks. The third test capped 2 months of civil unrest and division that left its mark on New Zealand and South Africa. Kushla Norman reports.
Smoke bombs have been thrown onto Eden Park.
The All Blacks fortress actually looking like one for the finale of the 81 Springbok tour. From the air, anti-apartheid protesters dropped flares and flower bombs, one striking a player as they tried to stop the game.
There's the players looking skywards as the plane comes
over. The commentator sounding composed, but he admits it was a distressing 80 minutes.
It's not an upbeat commentary voice because I was anxious, if not scared, some parts of that game.
22 to 18.
The match itself, a dramatic series decider, narrowly won by the All Blacks.
We couldn't bother about the plane because, I mean, the All Blacks, they are handful. So we've got to worry about the All Blacks and trying to win the test.
Meanwhile, off the field, violence had broken out. The climax of weeks of demonstrations against sporting contact with apartheid South Africa. The Boks weren't prepared for it. The former captain recalls one news conference.
And there was not one rugby question, and they just hammered us. That was really bad. I thought, my opinion was that we should have been open about South Africa, about the problems we had.
The protests also highlighted problems here.
One of our goals was to make sure that Pākehā New Zealand looked at racism here in New Zealand. And to that end, we were partly successful. We made a minor dent in the colonial attitudes.
In South Africa, the protests had an impact.
That was the beginning of the end of the last straw of changing the politics.
Senior All Blacks from that series declined or weren't available for interviews, not unlike 40 years ago.
We didn't hear much from the All Blacks on that tour. They were well looked after and there was a distance created.
1981, a divisive rugby tour bigger than the game that became a defining part of our history. Kushla Norman, One News.